Magandang gabi po, kapamilya. U.S. Marine Joseph Scott Pemberton now faces murder charges for the death of transgender Filipina Jennifer Laude. Prosecutors found basis to indict Pemberton for the October 11 killing, and Laude's family hopes that this is the first step towards a conviction. Doris Bigoria reports from Olongapo City.
In just a little over 2 months since Jennifer Laude was found dead inside a motel in Olongapo City, state prosecutors were able to file a murder case against the suspect, U.S. Marine Joseph Scott Pemberton. Laude's family and lawyers call this an initial success. They are well aware of the challenges that lie ahead, given that the accused is an American serviceman. No American soldier has ever served a full sentence in the Philippines.
Naasahan namin ang issuance of warrant of arrest kaagad-agad. This is a murder case, non-bailable. Kaya dapat sa buong panahon na nagkakaso ito, sa buong isang taon, dapat nakakulong si Pemberton.
On October 11th, Laude, a transgender woman, was found dead inside a motel room toilet. His body slumped against the toilet bowl. Forensics say he was bitten and drowned. According to several witnesses, Pemberton was with Laude inside that room just minutes before Laude's body was discovered. Pemberton's lawyers had insisted there was no probable cause to try the soldier for murder. If the case reaches the court, they had hoped it would be homicide. But the Justice Department says there was treachery, abuse of superior strength, and cruelty, enough reasons to call it murder. The Foreign Affairs Department lauds the prosecutors for a speedy investigation of the case. The DFA says it expects full cooperation from the U.S. government once trial begins. But the department also noted that provisions of the Visiting Forces Agreement should also be followed once trial begins. Outside the prosecutor's office, a small group of people gathered to call for justice for Jennifer Laude. With the initial victory, they vowed to press on and set the fight to the end.
Hinihiling na lang po natin sa ngayon na pagdating sa korte, sama-sama pa rin po tayo.
Doris Bigoria, ABS-CBN News.
And joining us now here at the ABS-CBN International Headquarters is Tina Schoff, Vice Chair of the Campaigns of Gabriela USA. Thank you for joining us here on Balitang America, Tina.
Thank you.
Tina, Joseph Scott Pemberton is now charged with murder. How confident are you about this case moving forward? Well, we heard Doris Bigoria said in her report, no U.S. serviceman has served a full sentence in the Philippines.
Well, we see this as a positive direction in charging Pemberton. We're fully committed in continuing to work with Jennifer Laude's family and also advocates in ensuring that that he's indeed sentenced. This charge. We've seen historically that in with the 2005 Nicole rape case, that Lance Corporal Smith also wasn't charged. That the charges were dropped. And we are committed to continuing to see through justice in this case.
Now, with this murder charge, Tina, how should the Philippine authorities deal with the issue of Pemberton's custody, especially if an arrest warrant is issued?
Pemberton should be fully turned over to the Philippine government. There should not be any kind of joint custody over Pemberton between the U.S. and the Philippines. Historically, the U.S. and the Philippines have had unequal relations with the Visiting Forces Agreement and also the Enhanced Defense Cooperation Agreement that was signed earlier in the year. Mm-hmm. We see this as these policies perpetuating gender violence and also trans violence towards the trans community. And it is perpetuated by this historically culture of violence between the U.S. and the Philippines towards the Filipino people.
Tina, why has the Jennifer Laude murder case become an important cause for the Philam community?
The thing that we want to emphasize in this case is that it's not just an unequal relationship between the U.S. and the Philippines. We want to emphasize that this is indeed a hate crime. What's being uncovered more recently is that Pemberton actually had confessed to a fellow soldier that he attacked Jennifer Laude after discovering that she was a transgender woman. And we want to highlight that this is a pattern of violence towards the trans community. Mm-hmm. We don't just see this as a violence towards a Filipino person in the Philippines, but that trans violence is happening all over the world.
All right.
And so with the recent trans murders around the U.S., like black trans woman Deshonda Sanchez, she was killed by gunshot in L.A. She was the third trans woman in California to be killed. And worldwide, there has been 226 trans murders.
So all right, and we all seek and wish for justice. Thank you very much for joining us here on Balitang America. Tina Shaw of Gabriela, USA.